This UCSD TV program is presented by University of California Television. Like what you learn? Visit our website or follow us on Facebook and Twitter to keep up with the latest programs.
We are the paradoxical ape. Bipedal, naked, large-brained, long the master of fire, tools, and language, but still trying to understand ourselves. Aware that death is inevitable, yet filled with optimism. We grow up slowly. We hand down knowledge. We empathize and deceive. We shape the future from our shared understanding of the past. CARTA brings together experts from diverse disciplines to exchange insights on who we are and how we got here. An exploration made possible by the generosity of humans like you. Welcome to this 24th CARTA Symposium. My name is Pascal Gagneux. I'm the Associate Director of CARTA. Among the oldest questions that humans have asked figure questions such as, who are we? What are we doing here? Where did we come from? How did we get here? And where are we going? Anthropogeny is the scientific quest to address two of these questions. Where did we come from? And how did we get here, that we at CARTA believe are addressable with scientific data from a great number of disciplines. Anthropogeny, it turns out, is a very old term that has vanished, and we have resuscitated. The Center for Academic Research and Training in Anthropogeny is an enterprise between UCSD and SOC, and it spans the general campus and health sciences as well as SOC. It is co-directed by Ajit Varkey, Fred Gage, and Margaret Schoeninger. Our MSO is Linda Nelson. Our community director, relations director is Ingrid Bernerschke-Perkins. Kate Kaya is in charge of all our computer and computer analysis. Jesse Roby, our program coordinator, and Steffi Petit, our administrative assistant. As I mentioned, trying to answer these two age-old questions will only be possible if we draw on the humanities, on biological sciences, engineering and computing sciences, as well as physical and chemical sciences, biomedical sciences, social sciences. Many of the people involved in these venues of studying humans are not used to talking to each other, at least not on a daily basis. So we really try to encourage regular interactions between scientists from very different fields. Our mission statement is the following: use all rational and ethical approaches to seek all verifiable facts from all relevant disciplines to explore and explain the origins of the human phenomenon. Doing so while minimizing complex organizational structures and hierarchies and avoiding unnecessary paperwork and bureaucracy. Unfortunately, there is also electronic bureaucracy these days. And we also try to do so in the process, raise awareness and understanding of the study of human origins within the academic community and the public at large, which is why these symposia are free and open to the public. I would like to point out that this is only possible due to many people who support us. First and foremost, the G. Harold and Leela Y. Mathers Charitable Foundation of New York, and Howard Chester, the executive director. I would like to take a moment to remind you that we've lost a very, very valuable friend and supporter who always supported our initiatives and really contributed greatly to the spirit of these symposia, but much more so of everything CARTA does. And this is Jim Handelman, who we lost earlier this year. He has come to many of the symposia. He has had an important role in shaping how we do this symposia. He was a very strong force behind the idea of involving a small group of highly motivated grad students to include them in this symposia. And we will miss him dearly. We have established a memorial symposium fund in his honor. We need to thank, and if you'd like to read more about Jim Handelman, our latest tracks, CARTA Tracks, which is a newsletter you can find as a PDF online or pick up copies outside, has a very nice, concise, two-page story of that will convince you very rapidly how crucial Jim was in the development of CARTA from very long time ago, when it was a small group of scientists on the Mesa here interested in explaining human origins, to the UCSD project for explaining human origins, to CARTA that started 8 years ago. We need to thank many other supporters, including Liz Lancaster and Ellie Schefter, that make possible the closed captioning on the recordings, and of course Annette Merle-Smith for the support that she provides for the graduate specialization in anthropogeny at UC San Diego. And we have a growing list of individual supporters who make these events possible. Thank you to all of them. And of course, none of this would be possible without a big team, a crew of people here at UCTV, Rich Vargo, Matt Aliotto, Marcy Bretz, Jacob Parker, as well as, of course, as the SOC Media Services, Ken Schnurker and Chris Schamp. So without further ado, one last thing. Some of you might not be aficionados of genomic or genetic sciences. If you hear acronyms that sound strange, you might want to pick up this two-page glossary that the specialization students try to generate, so to help you navigate the many acronyms that you usually hear in genetics and genomics talks. So with that, I welcome you all, and I'll pass the podium to Ed Green, who will chair the first half of the symposium.